I just read the 1974 novel Jaws by Peter Benchley, and then I watched the 1975 movie Jaws, directed by Steven Spielberg, starring Roy Scheider, Robert Shaw, and Richard Dreyfuss. Both are about a series of shark attacks that take place in a small beach town called Amity in New York. And this town's lifeblood is its summer tourism, so when these attacks happen, there's this dilemma of whether or not to close the beaches, and so three men take action to kill this shark so that life can get back to normal in this town. I'm going to briefly talk about the book and then briefly talk about the movie, and then I'm going to get into the differences between the two because there are a lot. And then at the end of the video, I'll tell you which one I liked better, the book or the movie. My opinion may be surprising to some of you, so you'll want to stick around. By the way, this video will contain spoilers about the book and the movie, so here's your warning. Before I get into my review, I wanted to take a quick moment to give a shout out to one of my subscribers who goes by Othello's Sorrow. They commented on my last video saying that I have, quote, wholesome dad energy. Not a dad yet, but I will be soon. My wife is due with our first child very soon. Anyway, thank you, Othello Sorrow, for that very cool and nice comment. All right, like I said, Jaws, the novel, came out in 1974, written by Peter Benchley, who states in the introduction to this book that he was fascinated by sharks ever since he was a child, and went on to read a lot about them and research a lot about them, and his knowledge of sharks really comes through in the book. He gets pretty detailed in a few parts about shark anatomy and biology and their habits. Like most of you out there, I saw the film before I ever read the book, and I expected them to be pretty similar and was very surprised with just how different the book is from the movie. The movie is rated PG, believe it or not, but the book is definitely R-rated, if you will. There's a lot of F-bombs that are dropped in the book, and Benchley gets really graphic at certain points with his descriptions of the shark attacks. So if you remember the iconic opening in the film, the young woman going skinny dipping late at night and getting attacked by the shark, that is how the book opens as well. But Benchley in the book describes the woman reaching down, trying to touch her leg, and nothing being there except for a bony nub. Ugh. And there's quite a few even more graphic descriptions. Also, there's a UF reference in the book, which I thought was cool. Go Gators. Quick side note, as I was reading this book, I suddenly realized just how analogous it is to the COVID-19 pandemic. Let me explain. So the shark is the virus, this hidden danger that's always kind of lurking out there. And the dilemma that this small town is faced with is shutting down its economy to combat this danger. All right, let's talk about the 1975 classic film Jaws, directed by Steven Spielberg. This movie is absolutely a childhood favorite of mine. I first saw it as a young boy. Not sure exactly how old I was, but did I mention that this movie's rated PG? And I instantly fell in love with it. It's such a great adventure tale of man versus beast, and the bravery and masculinity of the three men going out on their boat to kill this shark was just so captivating to me watching it as a young boy. This film is a great example of how the score, just a couple notes can turn an otherwise great movie into an unforgettable classic. And you have, of course, to mention, who else? John Williams. Fun fact about the movie, the guy playing the reporter on the beach in this scene is none other than the author of the book himself, Peter Benchley. When I was younger and watched this movie several times, my favorite character was always Chief Brody, played by Roy Scheider. But watching this movie now, I have so much more admiration and respect for the performances of Robert Shaw and Richard Dreyfuss. Of course, I always loved them, but I do think that now they are my favorite characters. Robert Shaw totally owns this role, and you feel like he was born to play Quint, and it just feels so real. And then you've got Richard Dreyfuss, totally different character, a young scientist. Dreyfuss brings such comic relief and humor, and the energy he brings to his role as Matt Hooper. is just so fun to watch. Now, I have to admit, watching this movie after having read the book this time, I did not like the first two acts of this movie as much as I used to. They're great, don't get me wrong, but I think the book does a better job getting across the gravity and magnitude of the moral dilemma that Brody and this town faces with closing down the beach and how big of a deal it is. The final act of this movie, however, when the three men are finally on the boat chasing and trying to kill the shark, is still amazing. One of the greatest final acts in movie history. Let's talk about the shark in the movie. Almost 50 years later, does it look corny? No, I don't think so. Obviously, special effects have come a long way, but I still think that the shark looks pretty good. It is such a technical achievement what they were able to pull off with this shark. I don't care what you think, this looks way better and more real than this. Okay, let's get into how the book and the movie are different. The absolute biggest difference between the book and the movie is the character of Ellen Brody, the police chief's wife. Ellen Brody is a deeper, rounder, much more complicated character in the book. She is a major part of the novel and almost an afterthought in the movie. In the book, Benchley goes into a lot of detail about how Ellen Brody has regrets about the path that her life has taken. She feels like she married down below her class when she married Martin Brody, and she often wonders, you know, what could have been if she had chosen a different path in life. And the character of Matt Hooper is described as tall and handsome in the book, and Ellen Brody and him meet and flirt and end up sleeping with each other. She has an affair with Hooper in the book, and Chief Brody ends up suspecting that something might be going on there, and that leads to some serious drama between Brody and Hooper. In the book, there's a major character named Harry Meadows. He is the local newspaper editor and reporter, and he has a lot of influence on policy decisions that are made in the book. He's very close with Chief Brody, and there is a character called Meadows in the movie, and I think it's this guy right here, and he has like a couple lines in the movie and is barely in it at all. The mafia also comes into play in the book, which was interesting. So the mayor of the town of Amity is in deep with one of the five mafia families in New York. They have some real estate dealings with each other, and the fact that the town is closed down is not sitting well with these mafia members. And one of them even comes to Brody's house and kills the family cat right in front of one of Brody's sons to send a message. In the book, the character of Quint is described as 6'4", skinny, and totally bald. And, you know, his amazing introduction in the movie when he screeches his nails on the chalkboard. One of the greatest introductions to a character ever. That's not how he's introduced in the book. He's kind of briefly mentioned, and then one day Brody just rings him up on the phone and says, "Hey, we need your help." Not as cool of an intro. And the whole storyline in the movie where there's this $3,000 reward, I believe, for somebody to catch and kill the shark, that is not in the book. And then, you know, in the movie you get the scene where the small group of fishermen actually do catch a fairly big-sized shark. That's not in the book. And then later, Brody and Hooper dissect that shark and pull out, you know, like a tin can and a license plate. That never happens in the book. All these things that happen in the, you know, second act of the movie, you might be wondering, well, what happens in the middle of the book? And the whole, like, there's a good 50 or so page portion of the middle of the book that is entirely focused on Ellen Brody having this affair with Matt Hooper. One of the more memorable parts in the movie where Quint is giving his USS Indianapolis speech.
So 1,100 men went in the war. 316 men come out. The sharks took the rest June the 29th, 1945.
A great moment in the film that gives you some much needed depth to Quint's character. That's not in the book. Hooper gets killed in the book. He gets eaten by the shark inside the shark cage. You're not that upset about that as a reader because of what he did with Brody's wife. So Quint gets eaten by the shark in the book too, but the book ends a little bit differently than the movie. So of course in the movie you got Brody who shoves the scuba tank in the shark's mouth and shoots it with a rifle, and then the shark explodes. Pretty cool. In the book though, you know, Brody's the last one left and the shark's coming after him and he just is prepared to die. He doesn't have anything left at his disposal. The shark is getting closer to him and then it just stops and sinks and it succumbs to its injuries that it has sustained. You know, a little anticlimactic, a little underwhelming. And then the book ends pretty abruptly. All right, so which one is better, the book or the movie? I honestly considered going either way on this one, which surprised me. I went into this review totally expecting to say that the movie's better than the book, but the book I thought was really good. I recommend reading it, especially if you're a fan of the movie. But at the end of the day, this movie is so special to me, and the performances of the three lead actors are so good. And the third act alone, like I said, is so damn exciting and well executed that I couldn't bring myself to say that the book is better, even though it is close. But I'm gonna give the edge to the phenomenal film by Steven Spielberg. All right, I wanna hear from you. Let me know in the comments below what you thought of the book or the movie, if you've seen both, read both, seen the movie, read the book. If you like this video, please do me a favor, click like, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, stay tuned for more videos in the near future. And there's only one thing left to say. Farewell and adieu to you, fair Spanish ladies. Farewell and adieu to you, ladies of Spain.